Have you ever walked through the children's section of a centuries-old cemetery? There are so many children's graves. Children died of smallpox, cholera, famine, bacterial infections, and unclean water supply. It's heartbreaking to think of all the families who suffered these terrible losses. But if you pay attention, you start to see a pattern in the tiny tombstones. As the years pass, there are fewer tiny tombstones, fewer dead babies, toddlers, and little children, less heartache and loss, more human potential. Why? Here's a graph of the percentage of children who made it to their fifth birthday from the year 1800 to 2020. In 1800, close to half of all children in the United States died before their fifth birthday. But life-saving scientific breakthroughs soon started to make a difference. For example, in 1850, Dr. Ignaz Semmelweis discovered the importance of washing hands to remove infectious particles. From 1851 to 1855, over 99% of the infants in his care survived, a figure hundreds of times higher than the norm at the time. In 1867, Joseph Lister introduced antiseptics, also saving thousands of lives. These methods, along with better sanitation in cities, saved thousands of children from cholera and other deadly waterborne diseases. In 1928, Alexander Fleming discovered penicillin to fight off bacterial infections like pneumonia and meningitis. To date, this breakthrough has saved over 200 million lives. In 1955, Jonas Salk gave us the polio vaccine, preventing an estimated 1.5 million childhood deaths worldwide. In 1963, Norman Borlaug used science to improve important crop yields like wheat. He is credited with saving upwards of a billion lives worldwide. Technology, safer products, modern medicine, humans have used science to improve the lives of all of us. Today, millions more children celebrate their fifth birthdays. Scientists and engineers have made this reality possible. And it's not just children. Adults can expect longer, less difficult lives thanks to science. Science saves. It's literally written in stone.